Hello everybody, I'm Dr. Amir Parekh from the Thinking Palette, and today I'm live with Stationery.plug, and we're going to be doing an ink and watercolor window illustration. So it's definitely going to be a fun session. I normally am known to create doors, so windows is something that's new for me too. I have very rarely done a window, but it's going to be fun because we're doing it from a live session. So we just wait for everybody to, of course, join in. Hello. So just for those who do not know me, I am Dr. Amay Parekh from the Thinking Palette. I am a dentist by profession. I am also a counseling psychologist and an art therapist. And of course, I love to paint and create art. I do a lot of ink and watercolor artworks. Hello, everybody. Hello. I know people are still joining in. So until then, if you guys have any questions, I'll definitely be happy to answer them. Yes, that's actually, I just sort of saw the t-shirt and I'm like, you know, I'll wear this today because it's matching the wall color. So thank you for noticing. And so a lot of people I know have joined in, so I'm really happy to see all of you guys here. If you all don't know what the materials are, please get an A5 size paper, watercolor paper, 200 or 300 GSM paper. I'm from Mumbai. I am a dentist by profession and art therapist and counseling psychologist. I've been painting since I was a child, but since 2015, I have been painting quite seriously and steadily. Yes, it is going to be saved on the IGTV of Stationery.plug. Hi, Pauravi. I am also excited today to see what happens, you know, because I've not done a window. Hello, Anita. So, let's see how it definitely turns out. I am looking forward to the session as well. So what can you do to make illustrations are not meant to be looking very real. Paintings, yes, you can definitely create them with proper depth, shape, shadow, using the right colors, using understanding the perspectives. Illustrations are not meant to look exactly like the real thing. They're supposed to have your own interpretation to it. Thank you so much, Kriti. I'm glad that people are getting motivated to paint. We'll wait for one more minute, guys, and then we're not going to be wasting too much time. I don't want you all to miss out on anything. As you all might be knowing, I love to teach and cover as much as I can possibly cover. Do share this live on your story so that people are aware that we've started the session in case they are not here and they would want to join. Okay? All ready? Can we start? I'm doing it on an A5 sheet. So this is what we're going to be creating today, okay? This is the photograph, okay? This is a photograph of some photographer. And I just randomly have a lot of, I keep looking at a lot of architectural photographs, doors and windows and stuff like that. And that's how I selected two options and we put a poll. And then of course people selected this. So I guess we're going to be doing this today. Alright, so I'm just putting this on the tripod. If you all have any problems in the screen audio, then please let me know. I will be really checking the comments from the other's phone as much as possible. In case I miss out on something, then please just give me a little excuse. Can somebody just let me know if the video is clear? In case the comments are bothering you guys, please just tap on the screen once, the comments will disappear. This is what we're going to create today. Can somebody give me a thumbs up? You all want to listen to Kenny G today? You all want to listen to some meditation music today? Whatever you want to listen to, we'll play that because I always have music on. But I want to listen to this today. You guys can let me know if the audio video is okay. All right, all good. So guys, now normally I do not recommend using a scale when we are doing an illustration, but I will show it to you so that you understand how I work, okay? I normally do everything freehand. I am not using a pen and pencil, okay? I am going to use the pen directly. I want you to try with the pen preferably and not use the pencil because you will understand how illustrations work better, okay? We are not doing a proper artwork, we are doing an illustration. Now what you need to understand first is the main photograph, okay? The subject of the photograph is of course the window.
forget the shadows, forget everything else, concentrate on the window. What we need to see, it's almost same. Of course, windows are looking symmetrical, so we have to try and keep the symmetry as much as we can in the illustration. Secondly, the bench is right underneath, you know, just below the window. So these are the two things we want to try and get in the line. Then we'll color the rest of the background, and then we will see how much of the shadow we need to bring inside. Okay, so that's how we have to analyze a photograph before we start the artwork. Alright? Awesome, guys. And I will keep showing the reference in between, but I can't keep it here because the window, the screen will get hampered. But in case you cannot see something, just let me know immediately, okay? So if you all are doing with a scale, okay, then what you're going to do is first make the top beam. So somewhere in the middle of the paper, leaving enough space on the top, okay? Leaving enough space on the top, okay? You're going to draw a beam that's maybe around, say, 7 centimeters long, okay? Approximately. This is what we're going to keep the top beam as, okay? Hi Devdesh, good to see you here. So this is what we're going to be doing. Alright, so you also how I use the scale. Now I'll show you freehand, okay? The same thing I draw downstairs. Make a small line on both sides, and with my hand I'm just drawing a parallel line. So this is with the scale and this is with my hand, freehand, okay? I really hope so. I've not done windows, so it's actually a fun session for me also. Right? Now once we've got this rectangle, we're going to make one smaller rectangle, leaving a little bit space down. And you try to see how I work freehand. Wherever you all feel uncomfortable, please use the scale. Alright? Whenever you feel that you're not comfortable, please use the scale. Anything will do, cold press, hot press, both will do. It's an illustration. I usually use cold press watercolor sheets. Alright, now what you need to mark here basically is you need to be in the center of this. So this is around, you know, I have kept around 7, so 3.5, you know, so that's 19.5. Why you need to keep the center is basically because when you're making the window, we want it to look more or less symmetrical. It doesn't matter if it goes a little bit here and there, but try and get this equal. I'm doing it on an A5 size paper. You can do it on any paper, guys, okay? I always tell you to, I give you measurements according to the paper. So even if you're using an A6 paper, this will fit in your paper, but you can always, you know, adjust the size a little bit. Now leave it, okay? Now what we're going to do is we are going to first draw two parallel lines. You can keep this about, say 5 centimeters. I think that should be enough. So this line you can keep 5 centimeters. This is little bit on the left of the midline. And leaving a little space equally on the other sides. So this is the center beam of the window. Okay, this is the center beam of the window that we have made. I'm using an A5 size paper, guys. Okay, I'm not using an A4 size. I'm using an A5 size paper. Now we got the center beam done, okay? We've got flowers here, so we're not going to complete this. We're going to keep this area open. What you're going to do, however, is on both sides. Again, if you're using a scale, then you will use it properly. So, say maybe around 2 centimeters or a little bit, 2.5 on both the sides you can keep. And 2.5, okay? So this is 2.5 centimeters on both the sides. This is just to keep the dimensions equal. When you're doing an illustration, even if you don't keep the dimensions equal, it's not going to be an issue. I will repeat what we have done so far, guys. We made a rectangle on the top. Then we made a smaller rectangle freehand. Then I marked the midline. Okay, I'm not getting any comments. Are you all able to hear me, or is the video paused? Can somebody just let me know? I've not got a comment, so I don't know whether it's going on, not going on, what is it? Alright, okay. Because I didn't get anything, so I didn't know whether you're following, not following. Awesome. Okay, so what we did, we made the second rectangle and then we made the middle beam. Now what you're going to do is the side of the window, okay? So same thing, you can just approximately either do it freehand, like I've said before, or you can use a scale. Both of the things are completely okay. So you can see it looks approximately equal. I don't know whether it is actually equal. I've drawn it freehand, but it doesn't matter. Okay? Draw. This will be around 5 centimeters. All of them will be around 5 centimeters. Okay? So this is also approximately 5 centimeters. Keep all these lines equal. Is the video pausing? Okay, I don't know what's happening, but from my side it's looking okay. Just that there are no comments coming today much, so I guess that's the problem. So we drew these two things and now we're going to draw the window panes, okay, the side of the window. So what you're going to do is you're going to extend this straight away on the side, leaving enough space on the side, okay. This has to be, you have to keep space on the side. And the same thing, you're going to draw another straight line. Okay, so we are basically making rectangles, rectangles, rectangles at the moment. Okay, can you all understand? We are just making rectangles. Only the lower half we have not joined anywhere. Rest, all we are doing right now is just making multiple rectangles. Same thing, you're going to extend the line here, approximately the same size, or if you're using a scale, please use exact measurements. Why I'm not using a scale is to show you that when I do illustrations, I don't worry about a little bit of randomness. Okay, because now I don't understand. Somebody said they are having an issue. Others are saying there are no issues. So I guess I don't know what's happening. Either way, in case people are having an issue, please do let me know. I'll stop. I'll re-explain what we did. Again, I'll tell you, we did the top beam. We did the middle beam. Then we made two side areas. And then we drew the two beams. Okay? I rarely ever use a scale, guys. Rarely. Okay, I always try to work freehand unless I'm doing a proper artwork where I need everything to be very, very precise. When I'm doing illustrations, I practically never use a scale. And we join these two, okay? Now these two you straight away join. So you know that your window panes are done, okay? These are the window panes, what you open and close, the shutters. Now what you're going to do is basically we have to understand that there are plants here. We are not drawing the plants right now, but what you're going to draw is just draw these kind of random outlines. Okay, just random outlines. So you know that this is where you need to get your bushes in. A very faint outline. Yes, please, I've said whoever wants to use a scale, please use a scale. It will be more precise for people who use a scale. I do it freehand because I enjoy the freehand process. Okay, everybody has their own process, especially like if you're a mandala artist, you're not going to like freehand, you're going to be doing a precise work. But I'm not a mandala person, I'm a sketcher. So when I'm a sketcher, I work with my hand. Alright, and below this, same way how we made this kind of a rectangle, you have to visualize that there's a rectangle, but this you draw a little bit faint, okay, because you don't want it to be seen. There's going to be plants coming over it. We are doing a window illustration. I'll anyways repeat all the steps, so don't worry, okay? And the same thing, you just draw this, keep this little faint, okay? We don't know how much we want to make it dark later on, how much we want to bring the pen on. So keep it a little lighter. What we are doing is we are making a window illustration. This is the photograph that we are converting into an artwork. There is enough space on the top, so I have left enough space on the top. This is the subject, so it's middle of the paper. What we did first is we drew the top beam. So that I've shown with the scale, and the rest of the work I've done freehand. Once we did that, we're going to just make two beams here and a center beam. The center beam has to be such that it is in the middle of the window. After that, we drew two rectangles on the sides, keeping these two almost equal as much as we could. If you're using a scale, you're of course going to be using getting exact precise measurements. If you're using the, and then if you're doing freehand, even if you go a little bit here and there, it's fine. Next, we make the window shutters. So again, two rectangles on either sides. And lastly, we did the flower area. Okay, let me just see the comments. I have missed a few. Okay, so thank you, the curious minds. Everybody else, thank you. I hope everybody is enjoying and understanding. I try to always keep it as simple as possible in my explanation so that everybody can follow. I'm using a 0.3 Brewstroke pen. You can use any pen, okay, don't worry about that. Just use a waterproof fine liner. Okay, are we good? Anybody who's not understood this, I'll quickly explain because we need to finish the sketch in the next 5 minutes, guys. There's a lot of coloring then. I'm using a Brewstroke technical pen, fine liner, 0.3. Right, whoever now wants to again use a scale is free to do so. Otherwise, with your pen only, just straight away, as if you're drawing a small rectangle within this, okay? And just join here. Okay? Same way, join here, like an L shape, you know, like an inverted L shape. See, I'm doing freehand, guys. So, my lines will be a little bit here and there, but for me, that is okay. So, if you all want to get straight lines, please use the scale. Now, in the middle of this, I'll draw another beam. In the middle of this, I'll draw another beam. Okay? So, we drew the center beams of the window, which is here. For the glass, okay, we drew the center beams. Awesome. Next, we are going to make small squares, okay? So, you draw the beam, but here what you'll do is you won't grow over this, you'll keep it under it. Okay? You can draw two or three squares. You don't need to draw all the squares, as many as there in the photograph. Okay? So, approximately like this, okay? Same thing you're going to do on this side. And over here. Awesome. Everybody's understanding. Anybody who's not understood wants me to repeat something. I am really missing the comments today, guys. So I don't understand. Are you all following? Did you understand the subject? Did you understand how we made the window? Any doubts in that? Anything you want me to re-explain? Okay, that's great. I guess now everybody is applying with their understanding. Yes, the session is going to be saved on the IGTV or stationery.plug unless some issue happens. Great. Okay, so once you have done this much, guys, what we are going to do is over here, we are going to make a small rectangle over here, okay? This is the plank area. On the top and a plank area on the bottom. Please, even it goes a little bit up and down, don't worry. Okay, one plank here, one plank here. And one plank here. Okay. One plank here. So can you understand, this is entirely done freehand. So there may be inaccuracies on the artwork, but still for an illustration, this looks absolutely fine. Great, I'll wait for one more minute, guys, then we start the bench area, okay? We can't wait for too long, otherwise we won't be able to color it then. For whoever has joined now, we made a basic square window. Here there's a plant, so we have assumed that the line would be somewhere here. And then drawn these plants. We've drawn the true window shutters. Thank you. I actually enjoy the freehand process.
I don't understand. Say your name as in.
Okay, now if somebody wants to do a little bit of pen work, you can do a little bit of rough pen work also in this. It adds to the look of the illustration, not compulsory. Okay, like a little bit of, with the pen only, I give a little bit of shading and then I add the colors. It gives a little more effect. This is not compulsory. Okay, like I can do this entire illustration only in pen also and make it look, you know, decent enough. No, I cannot frame so many artworks. Not possible. I have a file now. I have already framed over 50 artworks in my house. I cannot frame more. There is no place. Alright. Now we start with the bench area, guys. The same thing we are going to follow is we are going to work under this. Okay, so we are going to try and keep that symmetry. There's not much space that we have under this. So we just draw a line straight away. Try to keep it in this framework only. It'd be easier for you. Okay? And draw a first rectangle. Okay? I really like doing the wood actually with the pen. It looks very, very nice. Yes, I actually have a lot of artworks which are just lying now in the house. If somebody wants to buy them, please contact me. I will be happy to sell a few. Alright, okay, let's, once you've done this rectangle, we're going to now this is little important, guys. I want you to pay a little attention because this is how we are going to get the sides of the bench. Okay, can you see this curvature? I want you to see this curvature because if that it will be a little difficult to repeat. Okay, this curvature just represents that the bench is flaring up. We're going to be doing watercolor now. Keep it in a good folder, it won't get spoiled. My paintings are in a couple of folders and they are quite okay. My door paintings are in a folder, so, and I've done like a lot of door painting and they are really a lot of effort, so. Okay, so we are going to be doing illustrations and we are going to be coloring. Like these are all door illustrations. These are done in the other sessions. So these are all door illustrations. Windows, I'm actually doing a window illustration for the first time in a live. And I kind of enjoy the challenge. So that's why I don't paint priorly and create. And it's more fun that way. So those are all illustrations. Once you've drawn this bench, the lower part, okay, what you're going to do is you're going to again draw this straight line. And make this bench here. So it looks a little flared one. Yeah, Meeta, you've done almost everything, so I know that. Okay, then joining the lines over here, a line over here, as if, you know, you have to understand that the bench goes inwards, you know, goes inwards, because that's how the perspective will turn out. So you join this inwards. If you all have heard of a trapezium, okay, two sides going inwards and going broad on this side, that's what you're going to create here. Okay, and the front area of the bench. That creates our basic bench, and there's a wooden panel here, which I've not done, so I'll just draw that. Now what's very important is that you draw a horizon here. Why you need to draw a horizon is because it will look very weird. It's looking like the bench is hanging in the air. So always draw your horizon wherever you're doing an illustration or anything. that gives you a reference to work with, right? So we do this, and we now need to draw the back legs, okay? A bench has four legs, so you need to draw one back leg here and one back leg here. Did you understand? Four legs, okay? So now these legs look like they are in the front and these legs look are smaller and they are coming from behind, okay? You can darken them a little bit so you have an idea of what you're talking about. That's fine. Peace be Ankita, that's okay. I mean, that's entirely up to you. And one more line is here, so I'm just drawing these are just the reference lines, okay, because we don't have any other line in the artwork. There is a line on the top and on the small beam in the center on this side, but I'm not making them right now. We'll see if we need to add them. Okay guys, we'll take 2 more minutes. I need to start coloring then, so whoever has a question, wants to ask something not understood, I'll be happy to answer right now before we go ahead. Can I get a thumbs up, guys? This is a very silent group today. Awesome, guys. That's great, guys, that's great. So what we're going to do is we're going to start coloring, because otherwise we will never finish the artwork. Okay, that's okay, nothing is bad, everything is good. Never think that your work is bad, you're learning, and that's fine. So what we're going to do, guys, is I'm going to first put a little bit of color. We'll finish the in the background a little bit, so that everybody is on par, whoever has not reached. I'm going to wet the paper a little bit on the sides. Okay, we are not going to color the entire background. What I want you to understand is we are going to not color the entire background. We are going to actually leave it like an illustration. So some areas on the side, we actually just leave them white. That way it looks more illustrative and doesn't look like a painting. I'm wetting the paper right now. I have a big 12 number brush. You can use any brush. You don't need to wet the paper also if you don't want to. I'm just wetting it because it's a big area and I want to finish faster. Okay. Then I'm taking orange and a bit of gamboge. Okay. That's great to hear. Whoever is painting around, big, small, it doesn't matter. You should enjoy the process. Okay. So this is orange and gamboge together. I have basic watercolors, not using any fancy brand. I'm just taking the color and adding this basic color everywhere, okay, around the window. And see how I'll just leave it on the side, okay? I won't go all the way, I won't color the entire area, because we don't need to really do that much for an illustration. The more freer we keep it, the more realistic it's going to look. So a very bright yellow orange color. Again, I repeat, it's gamboge and orange mixed. Gamboge is a shade of yellow, between yellow and orange. If you take a very dark orange, the problem is only going to be that it might look too gaudy. But if you take a brighter color, even if you add shades with the, it's gamboge and orange. Gamboge you. And orange. Gamboge will be there in any watercolor set. How lemon yellow is there? The second yellow is gamboge. I'll show you all the tube also. this shade, okay? This shade. Okay, on both the sides I'm taking the color. And please see how I'm leaving the sides, okay? I want the sides to be empty. I don't want the sides to not chrome yellow. Ha, okay, chrome, not yellow ochre. Huh? Don't use yellow ochre. Chrome yellow is right. Okay, yellow ochre is mustard, okay? Mustard is dirty. You get a very dirty color. And take it behind the bench also, okay? Remember in the bench there are areas which are showing the wall, so you need to color those right now only. Alright, so you can see how nice it's already looking. Nice brightness is there in the artwork, okay? So we want to keep the illustration bright and lively, okay? We don't want it to be very dull. The brighter and livelier it is, it's going to look better. Okay, just adding a little bit of orange on the sides. Okay, wherever you need a little shadow, you can add a little orange now, or we can do it later. Okay, as I'm giving a little bit of a, you know, border sort of a thing, just for my own understanding as well as the effect of the shadow. This is only two colors, Camboge and orange, that have been used. How did I make the bench? That's already done, guys. Now I cannot restart the bench. But we did one rectangle, then we drew a straight line down, then we drew a trapezium, you know, like two ends are narrower and then they're coming out. Then we drew the four legs. And this is the handle of the bench. Okay. We crossed that stage quite some time back. It'll be a little difficult to go back to it. Anyone who's not understood something wants me to explain quickly. Now what I want you to do, see now the window over here has a very dull color, okay? Now the thing is, if we keep it so dull, it's not going to look very nice, okay? So we always keep the illustration a little brighter. So because the wall is of this shade, we are also going to keep the windows a little bit yellowish, because the blue and the green will then stand out more. I want you to understand. You can check the link in my bio for the brushes if you want. Yes, orange and gamboge have to be mixed together. Okay. Now what I want you to do, guys, is take this gamboge, okay, and very diluted, okay, keep a dilute kind of a mix and just apply on the window area. Very diluted, okay, don't make it very dark. Don't, we are not adding other colors, we are just keeping it bright and very diluted, okay. I'm again repeating, because the wall is that color and the window will look very dull, so we cannot keep a very dull color in an illustration. It will not stand out that much. So we are taking gamboge, very light gamboge, okay, like just water, more water, very less color. You can see I've not picked up the color again after taking it in the first area. I used a Brustro fine technical pen to draw. And the same thing I'm going to do here, okay? Same gamboge I'm going to use here. And light color everywhere. So there is just a faint effect of yellow, but it's not actually completely there, okay? It's just that effect of yellowness we want to bring there. Please do this now, because when this dries, we have to layer all of this. So please do this now. Okay, we are already a little behind expected time. Yes, you can color the entire page also. I like illustrations to have no end and keep it empty. You can color the entire area also. Right, that is my preference. It's not compulsory. That's what I'm trying to say. Hello Rukmati, long time I have not seen you only. How have you been? Yes, the live will be saved. Don't worry about that. I hope everybody is enjoying, guys. I like you all to keep responding, you know, then the session is more interactive. CD marker can be used for what? For drawing? Do you have this kind of a thin line? Then yes, because CD, they are also waterproof liners only. They are usually thicker in pick size. Okay, now straight away what we are going to do, guys, take your burnt sienna. Okay, take your burnt sienna. Again, light color, straight away apply everywhere on the bench. Okay, first we are applying the first coat. So straight away, video is stuck for you. Is the video stuck for everybody? I think half of the time we waste time in for this only. Is the video stuck, guys? Okay, so I've got no from somebody, so I assume it's working. Right, so straight away, like I said, first don't bother about anything and just straight away take burnt sienna and just apply on this entire bench. Okay, don't worry about the shade, anything right now, just straight away apply the burnt sienna. Okay, straight away apply basic burnt sienna on the bench area. Always do a wash layer before you start applying other layers, because it's difficult to correct otherwise. Okay, so straight away applying the wash layer. We need to finish the wash layer in the next 3 minutes, guys, so I want you all to buck up. Okay, otherwise you will not finish in an hour. And the same brown, okay, the same brown you can straight away apply even here. Even if your color is smudging, let it smudge. The same brown apply on the floor area. This is very light at the moment, guys. We are going to add a lot of color to it in the next layer. But all this needs to finish first. Okay. Next, once you have done this much, we are going to first color this area. So in this one patch, there is a brown. If you don't want to do the brown, we are going to just do the blue everywhere, okay? Because you are keeping the symmetry. So take cobalt blue. Okay, if you have ultramarine blue, this is the ultramarine blue, you can use ultramarine blue. Otherwise, just use cobalt, Prussian, whatever, any blue is fine. Okay, just use any blue. I'm using cobalt blue. And straight away just apply a first wash here. Okay, again I'll repeat, take cobalt blue light color and just apply. Don't worry about getting the shape and, you know, the beauty, everything right now. The first layer doesn't need to have anything like that. It just needs to get complete so that we can start working on the details. I'm using a basic camel watercolor, artist watercolors, nothing else. You can create, except for, I think cerulean blue is the only color which I think I miss in this. Otherwise I don't miss any other color. Okay, so adding the blue here, right, guys? I want you to buck up a little bit. Okay, little bit speed needs to go up. using basic camel watercolors. Basic. The first brand probably I started with, which I still use. Right? Now we're going to take a lighter shade of green. I use cobalt blue, okay? You're going to use a light shade of green, which is lemon yellow plus sap green. And you're going to give a little bit of patches here, okay? Give little bit of patches, leaving some areas empty, okay? Please leave these areas empty. Very, very important, because we want the red to come in. This is sap green plus lemon yellow, so it's very yellowish in nature and is a lighter shade of green. Okay, we'll have to wait for all this to dry, so we are going to start going a little faster now. I think student grade comes in plastic, but this comes in these tubes. This set is like at least since 2019, it's with me. It's packed 2019, so at least since then it is with me. Okay, now what we are going to do is we are going to do the top area and the other part of the area while this is still drying. So ideally I would not use black and gray, like, you know, but in this case, because it's not going to look bad, a little bit of black and white, and give it a slight tinge, okay? A slight shade, very watery, keep it very, very watery. Normally I use purple. If you all have attended my lives, you all know I use purple, but here it's just a very stony effect that we want to give, so a little bit of gray will look nice. Okay, take this a little on the windows also, very, very light. Can you see how light everything is? Please understand that first everything needs to be very light. I don't know if we'll go a little bit overboard of time, because we're going a little bit slower than I expect us to go. In case the live does end on its own, I will save the live and continue. I cannot show the bench right now, it's not possible. You can see the live again. This is sap green plus lemon yellow. Alright, and the same brown we are going to use in this area, but you're going to keep some green coming out, okay? So you can see why I did the green first. Can I explain which color? Sap green plus lemon yellow. Sap green plus lemon yellow. I have not used purple. I normally use purple for shadows. Guys, we're going to give you 2 minutes exactly to buck up. I've used cobalt blue. Okay, now let's start working on the details. Flowers we'll do now with the crimson, okay? We've not done yet. Now we are going to start doing some detail in the staircase. So taking dark burnt sienna, okay? So more color, okay? I will draw straight lines, leaving some areas a little bit lighter, okay? Start drawing straight lines, leaving some areas in between lighter. What happens? It gives more woody effect. Can you see how this is looking a little woody? Like wood, okay? Same thing you start doing here. Okay, we need to give the shadows also as much as possible. So guys, this needs to dry. I want you to hurry up a little bit. Below leaves is brown only, burnt sienna. Okay, now I'm using burnt sienna again to give more effect into the bench. Okay, only using burnt sienna right now, then I'll show you how to get a darker brown also in the third layer, and last comes the shadows. Ok okay, right now it's only the brown, but now I'm using enough color. Okay, you can use umber also. If you have umber, you can use a little bit of umber also, or you can just do it with burnt sienna. Okay, but see, always leave these lines a little bit in between. That gives the effect that that's more wood. Okay, it's made up of wood. Can you see the bench from 5 minutes ago to now? Just by one color only, by putting a second coat, we can see the amount of difference that's come in the bench. Okay. When we give the shadows, the effect is going to change. This is just brown only that I'm just using to give a little bit of depth. Awesome. See also how we did the bench area. Now we're going to finish the flowers till the time this is drying. I might go a little faster, guys, because you can see the light. Otherwise, we will not finish the artwork. Okay, I've gone quite slow. Now I'm taking crimson and I'm just leaving these kind of marks. Okay, we're not going to actually draw flowers, but you're going to draw these kind of marks. Okay, only with crimson. We're not using any other color. If you have different shades of pink or you want to create, then please go ahead, okay? But here, enough of just this much of this color will look enough. You can add a little bit of white if you want to get more pinkish. Okay? So you can see just by adding a little bit of this flowers also, it's going to give so much of an effect. And then once we add more leaves and that, the entire painting is going to start standing out so much more. Can you see how this is looking? Looking nice? So much work left to do, guys. So much work left to do. Okay. I'm not going to wait too much. Starting with the next step. Okay. Let's do this part of the window first. Take your cobalt blue. Now taking less water, okay, very less water, I want you to start giving strokes to it, okay? So you get this dry brush kind of a technique, okay? Start giving these kind of strokes. Can you see how this is looking? It's looking more wood, you know, looking more like wood now. Right? This is cobalt blue only, so as you can see, just with the same color also we can get so much effect. I'm using watercolor tubes, cobalt blue, right? Anywhere between the shadow, you're going to just make it a little more darker, okay? Wherever it comes on the sides, you're going to make it a little darker. Right, same thing on this side, because we need to get the entire window done, guys. We have not started the window yet and we have not started the shadows yet, so I don't want to waste too much time in that. Okay, same thing, dry brush, you can use your little bit more to get more depth in the artwork. Of course, you can use different colors. You can use Prussian blue also to get more depth. Just want you to see that how this effect is setting in. For those who don't know me, I'm Dr. Amey Parekh from the Thinking Palette, and I do a lot of ink and watercolor illustrations. I usually make doors, and this is the first window that I'm making. Probably I made windows before, but not an illustrative window. So you can see the effect I'm giving with the different shades. And now the shutters are looking so much more livelier than what we did earlier. Right? Thank you. It's still lots of work left, guys. Lots of work left. Okay, what we did is only use cobalt blue and a little bit of Prussian blue you can use, and we just use strokes. Okay, we put in strokes rather than putting in, you know, color. We put in these kind of strokes. So what these strokes do, it gives the effect of wood. And we have done a base layer already. We started at 6 o'clock. Okay. So now we'll move ahead, guys, because now it's very important. Please pay attention. Now we need to start paying a little attention. Take a smaller brush, okay? Now you need to work with a smaller brush. Any brush will do, but try to take a smaller brush. And you can use blue also, or you, if you want to create purple, you can create purple also. Blue will do enough because the window pane is blue. And start giving a little bit of shadow on this side. Okay, we are not creating like a curtain, but we are giving a little bit of strokes in the... When did I start watercolor painting? I've probably done since 7-8 years or more. Okay, and we're just going to make these kind of markings on the window. So we are starting to give a little bit of depth to the window, and you're going to follow this L shape. Okay, because if you see the original artwork also, there is shadow on one side only. So we're going to just follow that and just give a little bit of this L shape. You can use blue because the window panes are blue, so the blue will look nice. And that starts giving the depth to the artwork. My first painting was probably when I was 4 or 5 years old, I don't know, or probably a child, because I painted my entire house walls since I was a kid. The thing is, I used to do a lot. There are lives which I saved on my page where I have done acrylics. But since everybody is now recognizing this work, I'm trying to stick to it. But I like work with acrylics too. Okay, this is just cobalt blue, guys. Just cobalt blue that I'm just using to give a little shadow to the window. Okay, in this L shape. Okay, we're just using a little bit of cobalt blue and giving this L shape. Okay, so once we do this, what happens is automatically it looks like there is a little bit of depth in the window. For if we get time, we are going to, I'll show you all much more details also. But let's see, I don't think we'll have that much time. So I'll show you what we need to do in a basic illustration. I try to cover as many techniques as possible, even if it's a live session, but then of course we are restricted by time, so I need to take care of that. But can you all just make out, even by just putting this much, now the window looks more realistic. If you are a little bit of an expert, you can make some lines like this. It gives the effect of glass. So I am a dentist by profession. I am also an art therapist and counseling psychologist, but I have a passion for art, and I decided to pursue a second career in art and art therapy. So I am a professional artist in that aspect, but I like teaching more than anything. So just adding a little bit of, can you see how by adding a little bit of depth in the window, in the shadow, you know, this kind of effect, it looks more realistic. Okay, can you see the effect has come in much better now? We still have to work with the shadows, so let's start proceeding forward. Now we are going to use a little darker shade of green, so maybe just use your sap green, don't use any yellow, and start giving a little bit of leaves to it. Okay, you can add in between if you have confidence, and you're supposed to actually use all the colors a little bit here and there, so you get a nicer shade. So now 3 days a week, four days a week I go to my clinic and I work there in the daytime. I'm based in Mumbai. Okay, now can you see this green is coming in? How is the session going, guys? Are you learning, enjoying? Not understanding something? I'm just using greens now to add more leaves, okay? So can you see by adding some more leaf, it's looking much more realistic now. I am based at Kandivali. My clinic is in Grand Road. Can you all see by adding these leaves now, suddenly this plant looks so much more alive. And the same thing, I'll add a little bit of brown in these areas. Okay. Now I want you to pay a little attention, guys, a little bit of attention, because now we're going to start working a little on the shadows. So for the shadows, I would recommend now we go to purple. Can you explain windows? I didn't understand your question. Can you explain windows? Is a little can I explain the glass in the windows? We did an L shape because that's the shadow effect that we want to give. And we use a lighter yellow so that it remains in the composition, basically remains the same, you know, we don't change the composition of the artwork. Okay, did that answer your question? I don't know. So whoever is still following, guys, now we are going to use purple. Purple is obtained by mixing crimson and Prussian blue. It is already 6:56. I will try to finish by 7:50 any which ways. But in case the live ends on its own, I will save the live and come back on the live. But that will take another 3 to 4 minutes, okay? Now we're going to start with the shadows, guys. So what we're going to do is take this purple and make lines with this, okay? Like I said, I always use purple ideally. But the first basic shade was okay to do with the black, so I did that. Can you see this now effect because of the shadow? Please see this carefully, guys, because the shadow is where it's going to change the entire look of the artwork. Okay. Can you see this effect from what it was? Now so much depth has come in the window. Okay, so that's how you use purple to get this kind of a nice shadow to it. Okay, I'll also add shadows behind this. Okay, now this is not dried, so I'm just being a little careful. It may smudge. But even behind the bench, you know, we need to give the effect that there is a shadow there. So this is just purple. Okay. And a little bit of brown to it. Can you all see the effect that this little bit of color has made in the artwork? Same thing in the bench area. I want you to understand that by adding just a little bit over the shadow also, there's going to be a lot of tremendous change in the artwork. So even if you keep it at this much, now the painting looks quite finished, you know. Even if you don't want to give more details, this painting now looks quite finished. Anybody has any suggestions, anything they want me to re-explain or, you know, has not understood? Wanted to show you all this effect because the shadow is where the whole look changes. Okay, why did I ask to get white pen? Actually, there's a curtain inside which I have not drawn. I will not have the time. Otherwise, if you want to get the curtain details inside, then actually we need to do with the white pen. I'll see if we can do a little bit of it. It's not dried, so I can't do it right now. There's a white curtain inside, which is why I had asked for this. If you all want to make the shadow of the tree and everything, you all can. I would not really recommend it because now the entire window looks very nice and finished. Okay? So even if you don't add that, this looks really good. Let me just remove the masking tape so you guys can see the final outcome till that time. Actually, in this artwork, there is a tree which is not seen. So we are just doing it on the sides. Ideally, we need to see that there is a tree here and we need to replicate those shadows. So here we are just following as if it's just falling on the top and we are just taking the shadows from the side. One second. Okay, so I hope everybody's enjoyed. My Instagram handle is at the Thinking Palette. I'm Dr. Mayur Parekh. A lot of you all must be knowing me probably, hopefully. But this is the way we've done the artwork, and I think it's come out pretty fairly well. The window looks like a nice illustration. Okay. If you all want to create a little bit of a, you know, like a curtain inside, you all can. You can even use a little bit of white in your windows to give it more kind of a wood effect. Okay, even in the bench and all, it does look nice. I really like using whites to accentuate the highlights, but this is not compulsory. Okay, basically for the curtain I had asked, but we've not drawn the curtain because we won't finish it otherwise. But I think the outcome is looking pretty nice. The window is looking proper, like an illustration, and the colors are bright. Artsbook, you asked something to tell, but I don't know what you've asked me to tell. The shadow, I said, we are taking from the top, as in from the top. Actually, there in the photograph, there is a shadow from the front side because there's a tree there. We've not done that, so we've taken the shadow from the top. So if you see all the area, the shadows are underlying it. Okay, I've drawn the shadows already. Can you see this? I've drawn the shadows already. We don't need to add more shadows to this. I'm not drawing the tree because the tree will take away the look from the window. Okay, if we were doing a painting, probably it would have made sense. But when doing an illustration, that look will go away. The shadow look is already there in this much. Okay, so that is the artwork for today, and I hope all of you all had fun. Yes, of course, you can add whatever you want to. There is the complete freedom from my side. I'm just showing you what we had to cover in the live session, and that's it, guys. So that's me, Dr. Amay Parekh from the Thinking Palette, and I hope all of you all had fun. Please do share this live to your friends, put it up in your paint. Do tag me at the Thinking Palette, tag stationery.plug, and it's always good to be online and teach. So thank you everybody, thank you for joining in, thank you for staying for the session, and anything else that you need to ask me, anything that's left, then I will answer that quickly before we of course go in the end the session. Thank you guys, thank you so much, thank you for being here, thank you for all the compliments, thank you. You won't get the same effect that I've done. You can of course do that, but you won't get the same effect. Okay, it's completely acceptable if you want to trace it later. Alright, so see you then guys, bye bye, take care, have a safe weekend. And check out my page at the Thinking Palette also. Bye bye. I didn't get you, sorry. The photograph. This is what we've done. Okay, this is what we did today. I've used paper from Anupam, 200 GSM Anupam A5 size paper, watercolor. Okay? I just said A5, 200 GSM watercolor paper, cold pressed. Awesome, guys. Thank you.
Bye bye.